Hello, my name is Rainer Hanekamp, and this is Engine News with the latest updates from the Angular community every week. Lately, the hot topics in Angular have been around signals and hydration. Last week, though, took a different turn. At the JetBrains JavaScript Days, Jeremy Elbourn, head of the Angular project, gave a talk titled Evolving Angular for the Long Run. He covered ongoing improvements like signals and hydration and shared how the Angular team is learning from the past decisions to build a framework fit for the next 10 years. At the end, Jeremy surprised everyone by showing three new component formats, which look completely different than those that we have today.
And I do want to emphasize that these are ideas. This is not an announcement that something is happening, just ideas. What if you could author an Angular component using a very TypeScript first function syntax where your component is a function? What if you could author an Angular component to use a more HTML first syntax? Or what if you could define a component with a CSS like syntax where you have a rule and it has properties? Okay, probably not this one.
And while Jeremy emphasized that these are still very hypothetical, the fact that members of the Angular team like Alex Recapo, Pavel Koslovsky, or Matthieu Riegler started to actively ask for feedback on X, that suggests that certain kind of changes might be more serious than it looks like. In other news, NX, an alternative to the Angular CLI, was released in version 20, bringing new features. For example, the switch to ESLint flat config and an option to use RSpec as a bundler alternative to Webpack or ESBuild. Also, release management has been improved with new features like release groups, which let you publish multiple packages simultaneously. Finally, the resource function is still generating buzz. It will integrate asynchronous tasks into signals. We will have to wait for Angular 19, and it will be available as an experimental feature, but still, content about it keeps coming up. Recently, Manfred Steyer published an article and Joshua Moroni released a complete video covering its details.
The Angular team are on the path of making RxJS optional, and I feel like we are now close to a state where that is becoming viable.
That's it. Wishing you a nice weekend. See you in the next episode. Goodbye.